guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to do, I guess, like the ultimate no makeup makeup look. It's for those of you that go to the gym that just need a little bit of coverage just for confidence. Some of you will be the type of people that go to the gym and you are heavy on the cardio, you might be sweating profusely and thinking makeup is just a no-go for me, and that is absolutely fine. Now this makeup isn't for those of you that are going to be sweating profusely. It's going to be minimal on the skin, but at the same time, if you are heavy sweating, then it will probably just come off. I tend to do a lot of weightlifting, and if I do cardio, it tends to be steady state. I'll probably do like an incline walk. I'm just not a heavy sweater, so I get away with like a little bit on days where I feel like I just need a little bit of extra confidence. We all have it. Sometimes during our cycle, we're feeling a little bit less confident, a little bit down on ourselves, and having a tiny bit of makeup on just gives us confidence to just go out there and feel like you're not going to be stared at. Nobody really is staring at you. They're all thinking about themselves, but it does help when we feel a little bit more confident. So that's what I'm going to do today. So I've already done my skincare and I've got some SPF on, so I'm going to just target areas of my face that I feel are my bugbear, which tends to be a bit of redness around here, uneven colouring on my eyelids, and I have a little bit of melasma showing because it's the summer. Also, I have colour on my body just from walking around in the sun. It's the summer here, you can see it's super bright outside at the minute. I will sweat more sitting here filming this than I will going to the gym. So for me, because I always wear sunscreen on my face and a hat if I go out, my skin always tends to be a bit paler than the rest of my body, and that in itself makes me feel a little bit self-conscious. So to give my skin a little bit of extra colour, I'm going to go in with the Dr. Jart BB Beauty Balm. I've shared this before, this is a tinted SPF, so although this does give a little bit of coverage, it still allows your skin to show through if you've got any freckles. It still wouldn't necessarily cover my melasma, but it definitely helps to kind of minimise it, and it just gives me a little bit more confidence. But I do really only use a tiny amount, much less than I would if I was just going about my regular day. I would apply a little bit more for additional coverage, but for the gym I really only apply a very tiny amount. So as you can see, I take like half a pump, and I've mixed two shades together in this because I am between light medium and fair light, which is typical. I really hope that Dr. Jart bring out a couple more shades. So I've just quickly pinned my hair out the way a little bit. If you can hear creaking, it's my stool, sorry. So I'm going to mix these together. It really is just a very light layer. And I'm just going to pop it in the areas that I need just a little bit of tint to take away that redness. You can see straight away it takes away the redness in my eyes. And it goes on lovely because I've got SPF on. I've got the Vichy Mineral 89 SPF 50, yeah. So around my eyes, it's so lightweight that you can't even see it on the skin, but it just evens out my skin. It gives me a tiny bit of colour. I'll use what's left on my fingers just to pull that down my neck. And then pat it in. Your fingers work like a sponge. They get rid of any streaks. You can see it just gives this really nice kind of radiant glow. I have to tone the glow down a little bit because I am oily, and I think you'll probably want to do the same if you're going to the gym, because you probably will get naturally glowy from your workout. So if you just pop a little bit of powder on, it'll prevent you getting too shiny. You can still see my freckles, you can still see my pigmentation, but it just looks much more even. For me, it is all about feeling awake with makeup. So for me, the inner corner of my eyes are getting slightly kind of more hollowed as I'm aging. So I like to just pop a little bit of brightener on the inner corners of my eyes and just a little bit on the outer edges of my eyes, just because this area is really thin and it gets thinner as we age. So having that look a little bit more kind of even with the rest of my face makes me feel more confident and awake. So I'm going to take a little bit of this corrector by Huda Beauty. This is Cherry Blossom. Now you could just go straight in with just a regular concealer. You don't have to color correct, but this is great if you have like blue tones or purple tones. This will help to eradicate any darkness that's there. So you could use your finger. I tend to use a brush just because I've got nails and I find that a little bit more difficult to get to the inner corner of my eyes. But you can just use your finger to blend it. It's a little bit easier to press it in, and it's so much thinner in consistency than the regular Faux filter concealer, which we would put on top. So you don't have to worry too much about applying too many layers because it's very, very thin. this is not meant to completely cover your dark circles, it's to correct them so that when you put concealer on top of it, it still looks like a concealer shade. Does that make sense? Because sometimes if there's darkness underneath your concealer, then the concealer becomes ashy looking. But if you colour correct it first, which will still look slightly off than like natural skin, the idea is it's neutralising that darkness so that when you put concealer over the top, it doesn't look ashy underneath. I hope that makes sense. So again, just popping a little bit of that on the inner corner of my eyes. This will take longer because I'm sitting talking you through it. It literally takes me less than 5 minutes to do in the morning. And I don't always do it. Sometimes I go with absolutely no makeup on. I'm also going to pop a tiny bit of this colour corrector on my melasma, so that when I put the concealer on, it's neutralised this pigment underneath and it will cover just a little bit easier. Don't have to be too neat about it. I've got a little bit here. Then I can go in with the HUDA Beauty Faux Filter Concealer. The shade I have here is Coconut Flakes and it's neutral. Again, I'm going to use a little brush to do this. Pop this just on the inner corner or anywhere that you have a little bit of redness, unevenness, darkness. Anything that you feel is your bugbear. You see how that just brightens? It just makes me look more awake and I feel like a little bit younger with it in a sense because I never had darkness in this area when I was younger and that's only really starting to occur now. So I'm going to take a tiny bit on the outer corner, pat it in with your finger. And then I use what's left on the brush just up here because I have a bit of redness just on my eyelid. And the beauty balm is not sufficient enough with the little amount that I use just for the gym to cover this redness. So I use what's left on my bristles just over my eyelid. So it looks a little bit more even. So just pat that in with your fingers and again use what's left on the bristles to take that over any areas on your face that you find you've got a little bit of extra redness. It's really about using like the minimal amount if you want it to look natural. A very light veil is all you need to conceal. The skin still looks like skin, and if you were talking to me in the gym, you probably wouldn't notice that I was wearing makeup. I have a tiny bit of redness just here. So I'm going to conceal that. And that's it really in terms of concealing. I know some of you will have less than I have to conceal and some people have more and that's perfectly fine. Pop a little bit on there. Pop it on with your brush and then pat it out with your finger, then the edges will be seamless and you can see it's more or less disappeared. I'm just going to do the same with this little bit up here. Much more even. Now, as I said, for me, I am oily combination, so having this glow to my skin, as beautiful as it is going to get a little bit more glowy at the gym, so I want to take it down just a little bit. I'm going to take a tiny amount of the Charlotte Tilbury Airbrush Flawless Powder, which is really, really minimal, and just take down the shine. And I tend to only do this through the T-section. You don't need to look powdery, but just enough that those little areas that you've popped concealer on will stay in place. A little bit through, and I have to put it on the areas that I've put the concealer, like on my melasma. And then I tend to just use what's left on my puff, which is next to nothing, just everywhere else. So I don't look powdery, but it's kind of setting it in place. I will pop a little bit more on my eyes, like I'll take a bit extra just on my eyes because that's where the majority of that concealer went, so that'll make sure that doesn't move. And also this adds a bit more brightness, but I won't take it underneath my eyes because that's when you start to get into trouble with fine lines and wrinkles. I would rather it move on my skin and then me just pat it back into place than to look powdery and dry underneath my eyes. Just a couple more little bits to make me feel a bit more confident. This is optional, you don't have to do this. Curling your lashes will just open up your eyes and just make you look a little bit more awake. I feel like it just makes you look a little bit more feminine as well, because our eyelashes naturally tend to be a bit straighter. So giving them a little bit of lift just makes them look more feminine without wearing mascara. So I'm using my Rephr lash curler, and I like to give them a good little pinch. And you can see it just makes the world of difference to my eyes. You can also tilt your curler backwards slightly, and that'll give you extra lift. And if you can see, makes the eyes look more awake, right? I'm gonna take a little bit of bronzer, just on a big fluffy brush, and I tend to just pop this where the sun would hit. It's like super quick. So across the hairline, a little bit across the bridge of the nose, and across your top to your cheeks. Literally just that, because again, I have colour on my body. My face really does stand out as not having much colour. I don't bother to fill in my eyebrows, I don't put mascara on, I don't put any blush on. The only thing I like to do is pop a little bit of lip balm on, that's more for comfortability. I really love this one by Lancome. This is the Glow Butter in number 10. It smells beautiful, it feels so comfortable, and it's really tasty. And it adds this very, very subtle pinkness to the lips, really. So that's it. That is all I do for my gym makeup. You can see it just looks super natural. The skin still looks like skin. It really is like the ultimate no makeup makeup look. I always put my hair up at the gym. Sometimes I wear it in plaits. Sometimes I just put it up in a little Tinkerbell bun because I wear my earphones at the gym. I'm gym ready. I feel much more confident. My face just feels like I've woke up like this. You can see I've got a lovely glow from the tiny amount. I mean, you saw it was half a pump of the beauty balm. So I hope you guys found that useful. And if you've got any questions on this, or if you need any advice, leave them in the comment section below and I'll do my best to get back to you. I'll list and link everything I've used in the description bar. So let me know if you try this kind of ultimate no makeup makeup look. And I will see you in my next video. Thank you so much for watching. Please subscribe if you are new to my channel. It's free to do so. Just hit the little subscribe button below and hit the notification bell so you don't miss any of my future uploads. And I will see you in a couple of days with another video. Bye guys.